When he became the state attorney general, he was ready to deal with white-collar criminals and legal issues to protect Utahns. However, Sean Reyes says he quickly learned protecting people also involved hitting the streets and going after human traffickers, drug dealers, and others. Tonight, we catch up with the attorney general and are behind the badge report.
A couple months later, they were all out on the street.
Yeah.
His job is to enforce the law and protect the people of Utah. And Attorney General Sean Reyes takes those duties seriously.
Whether it's their computer systems, their identity, their bank accounts, or their lives, these are all things that the men and women of the Utah Attorney General's office fight to protect every single day.
Reyes says there's so much crime and so much to do. He often puts in 80 hours or so of work each week.
You could give me 10 or 12 more investigators and agents, 3 or 4 more prosecutors, and I could keep them all busy.
Reyes was appointed to the position by Governor Herbert at the end of 2013 and then was elected in 2014 and 2016. When he took over the office, he says he was ready to get to work.
We have created in the state AG's office a whole white-collar crime unit. Some of our investigators have spent decades specializing in those types of cases, and we bring them on very complex cases where you're chasing money across jurisdictions or even countries to go after the perps. There is far too much white-collar fraud and Ponzi scams and schemes, and so we're hitting that white-collar side really, really hard.
The 46-year-old attorney expected those types of crimes, but about a month into the job, he says he was hit with something he didn't expect.
Kids getting sold and pimped out and forced to mule drugs and being abused for sex. That was shocking to me.
Reyes was so disgusted with those involved in human trafficking and felt so much compassion for the victims, those types of cases became priorities. And he soon found himself out with investigators during raids, sometimes to support, sometimes undercover.
I really wanted to get to know what they were doing, to stay out of their way and let them do it well, but really to empower them to have the resources that they sorely needed.
Reyes admits to being fascinated with superheroes, and he has the toys, the books, and other memorabilia in his office to prove it. But he says working with law enforcement officers has given him a whole new appreciation for real heroes.
These men and women behind the badge, the ones that you're highlighting, they're real superheroes. They really go out, not in some comic book, but every single day.
Reyes says state investigators often work side by side with local and federal agencies because it takes that type of team effort to bring down the bad guys.
They're working with us on our Internet Crimes Against Children task force, hunting down the worst predators that you can imagine who will exploit children for child pornography, child sex, and human trafficking.
Reyes says no matter where you stand on immigration, everyone needs to know, even if they don't see it, Utah has a very real problem with labor trafficking and the exploitation of undocumented immigrants.
I mean, there's a closet industry of people who would prey on the undocumented because there's such a hyper population.
He is so passionate about bringing traffickers to justice. He has also helped train agencies in other countries like Mexico and Haiti. And he says, whether it's in Utah or across the world, it's all part of the same fight.
We have to address these types of issues domestically and locally. We'll hit them hard here. But if we don't help our friends and create a firewall globally, all of that stuff keeps threatening our jurisdictions and our borders.
And Reyes says a lot of people ask about his heritage. He says he's Hispanic Polynesian, and he is the first ethnic minority to serve as AG in the state of Utah. To learn a bit more about him and his past and his family, you can go to our website, also check out the old Behind the Badge stories, and nominate someone for a future